Switching over from Windows to Mac can feel intimidating, but it doesn't have to be. Let's make macOS feel at as home and tell you all the things you need to learn to get started. macOS has several cornerstone features that you need to understand to get the hang of the operating system. These include the dock, spotlight, finder, trackpad, menu bar, control center, and more. We'll cover all these features one by one, and if you watch the video from start to finish, we promise you will feel right at home. First thing first, you need to remember that everything you use control key for on your PC works with the command key on your Mac. It will take a few days for your muscle memory to change and learn this new behavior, but you will get used to it quick enough. Now, on to our tips. The first thing you will notice when you turn on your Mac is the dock. Consider the dock as the Windows taskbar, which lets you quickly launch your most used apps. You can add any app on the dock to quickly access it. Whenever you launch an app on your Mac, its icon automatically appears in the dock until you quit the app. If you want the app to remain in the dock even after you quit it, right-click on its icon and go to the Options menu and choose the Keep in Dock option. You can access all the installed apps on your Mac using the Launchpad icon. From here, you can drag and drop an app to the dock to keep it there. By default, your Mac dock will be filled with Apple's default apps. To clear your dock to make space for apps you actually use, simply click and drag the app out of the box and hold for a second till you see the remove text. Now let go and the app will get removed. The recent apps section of the dock holds your three most recent apps. If you don't want to see this section, you can remove it. Right click on the separator line and choose the dock settings option. Here, disable the option for the show suggested and recent apps in the dock option. While we are in the settings page, you can also change the size of the dock, its magnification, and choose how your minimized apps behave. By default, when you minimize an app, it creates a separate space in your dock. You can enable the toggle next to Minimize Windows into Application icon to change this behavior. You can also change where the dock appears on your Mac. Like Windows Taskbar, the dock is present at the bottom of the screen. However, you can use the Position on the Screen setting option to keep it in the left or the right side of your desktop. The final thing about the Mac dock you should know is how to automatically hide it. If you don't want the dock to be always visible, you can enable the toggle next to the automatic hide and show dock to hide it. It will automatically appear and disappear when you move the cursor near to the edge of the screen. You can also manually show and hide the dock using the Command Option D keyboard shortcut. And that's all you needed to know about the dock. Now let's move on to one of the best features of macOS, which is Spotlight. The Mac Spotlight is its heart and soul and arguably far better than the Windows search function. You can quickly access Spotlight using the Command Space keyboard shortcut. You can use it to find almost anything on your Mac. To launch apps, type the app's name and hit enter. One pro tip, you can quickly find apps using only its initials if you want. You can also use Spotlight to find files and even text within files. You can also use it to perform simple calculations, currency conversions, look up weather information, and do so much more. We have already published a video on how you can make the best of Spotlight on your Mac, which you can view by clicking on the I button and using the link in the video description. Now, let's move on to one of the best hardware features of the Mac, which is its trackpad. Before you start learning about your other Mac features, you need to learn how to navigate your Mac using its amazing trackpad. The Mac's trackpad is a plain joy to use. Once you learn its basics, navigating the macOS system will be a cakewalk. macOS settings page has a comprehensive tutorial on how to use the Mac's trackpad, so let us start there. To open settings, click on the Apple menu bar icon and choose the system settings option. Now, scroll down the left sidebar and choose the trackpad option. Here, you can change the tracking speed and the intensity of the click and enable force click features. To make your Mac's trackpad behave closer to its Windows counterpart, you can enable tap to click feature. Also, you can set the right click to click in bottom right corner if you are used to that behavior on your Windows laptop. We recommend keeping it to click with two fingers, as once you get used to it, it's far more comfortable. With the basics done, now click on the scroll and zoom section. You will notice that you can pinch in and out on your trackpad, just like you do on your smartphone to zoom in and out on photos, web pages, and more. Another feature is the double tap to zoom. It will allow you to double tap on anything to zoom in on the cursor location. In the More Gestures setting, you will notice that you can swipe between virtual desktop using three fingers and open Mission Control that shows all your apps using the three finger swipe up gesture. Finally, you can pinch in with three fingers and thumb to open Launchpad and pinch out to reveal the desktop. Don't worry if you cannot remember all these gestures right now, you will get the hang of it as you use them more and more. Just remember to come back to this page whenever you forget something. Now, let's move on to Finder. Finder is the file explorer of Mac, and I must say, It's pretty useless in its default configuration. We need to customize it to make it more familiar and useful. By default, when you open a Finder window, it shows you the recent files folder, which might not be useful to you. You can change this behavior by using the Finder settings. Launch the Finder app and use the Finder menu bar item to open settings. Under the New Folder window option, you can choose from preset locations or choose any other folder you want using the Others button. We like to keep it selected to Downloads as most of the time we want to access the download folder. While you are in the settings page, click on the sidebar option to select what you want to appear in the Finder sidebar. Remove any folder that you don't want to see in the sidebar to declutter your Finder window. For example, we don't want to show recents, movies, photos and music folders, so we will remove them for a much cleaner experience. Another thing missing in Mac's Finder by default is the file path. It makes navigating through your Finder window quite disorienting, especially if you have just switched from Windows. Thankfully, you can add the path bar to Finder by going to View menu and choosing Show Path Bar option. You can also enable the Show Status Bar option to view pertinent information like number of items in a folder and the remaining storage space on your Mac. Finder also lets you customize how you can view your files in the window. Click on the View drop-down menu and choose the view you want. You can also quickly switch between these views using the keyboard shortcut command 1, 2, 3, and 4. Depending upon what view you love the most, you can set it as default. Before we move on from Finder, here's a pro tip. You can add any folder to your Finder sidebar by dragging and dropping it to the sidebar for quick access. Now, let's move on to Menu Bar and Control Center. Think of Menu Bar as a status and action bar that lets you access secondary menus for apps, perform actions, and even run Mac utilities. Whenever you launch an app, you will see its items displayed in the menu bar in the left side. You can use these menu bar items to access all the settings for these apps. The right side of menu bar displays menu bar apps and Control Center. The Control Center on your Mac gives you a quick access to key macOS settings such as AirDrop, Wi-Fi, or Bluetooth. For quick access, you can drag and drop these settings out of the Control Center and into the menu bar. Similar to the dock, you can click and drag out any menu bar icon that you don't want to see there. Clicking on the top right corner of the menu bar will open Notification and Widgets panel, where you can see all the notifications and add widgets. By the way, with the macOS Sonoma update, you can also add widgets to your Mac desktop. You can learn how to use this feature by using the I button or clicking the link in the video description. Now that we have covered all the major features of macOS, let's learn about some keyboard shortcuts and quick tips to make your life easier. In any app, you can use the keyboard shortcut Command Comma to open its setting panel. There's no cut and paste function in Mac. Instead, you have copy and move. To move a file from one folder to another, copy it using Command C. You can create a duplicate copy of the file in a different folder using Command V or move to that location using the Command Option V keyboard shortcut. If you miss the forward delete key on your Mac, just hold down the function key and hit the delete key to forward delete text. There's a difference between closing and quitting apps on your Mac. When you close an app using the Command W keyboard shortcut, it only closes its active window while the app runs in the background. To completely quit the app, you can either use its menu bar item to choose the quit option or use the Command Q keyboard shortcut. While macOS is great at managing apps, some apps will still misbehave and freeze up. Like on Windows, you can force quit apps on Mac that are misbehaving. You can open the force quit menu using the Apple menu or using the keyboard shortcut Command Option Escape. Now, click to select the app you want to quit and hit the quit button. Alternatively, you can hold down the option key and right-click on the apps icon in dock to get the force quit option. You can minimize the app using the yellow button or Command M keyboard shortcut. Better than minimizing is hiding the app using the Command H keyboard shortcut. You can use the Command Tab key to move between different apps and Command Tilde key to move between the apps of the same window. One of the best features of the Mac is the preview option. Click to select a file and hit the spacebar to preview it. It works with documents, images, video, and audio files. macOS also has a built-in screenshot tool. You can use the keyboard shortcut Command Shift 3 to capture your whole desktop or Command Shift 4 to capture a part of it. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Command Shift 5 to open a screenshot tool that lets you even record your screen. Pro tip, when you use Command Shift 4 keyboard shortcut, hit the spacebar to turn it into a camera icon that will capture the active app window without you having to fiddle with the selection. On your Mac desktop, you can right-click anywhere and choose Show View option to change the icon size and grid spacing to show how your files appear on the desktop. If your desktop is too cluttered, you can go to the View option and pick the View Stacks option to organize same files in stacks. macOS only shows scroll bar when you start scrolling. You can still click and drag on the scroll bar but it goes away as soon as you stop scrolling. If you want the Windows experience and want the scroll bar to be always visible, use the Apple menu to open System Settings and in Appearance setting, select Always for show scroll bars. Aligning Windows on Mac is broken and probably the one thing that will pain you the most as a Windows user. You have to click and hold on the green button and it takes a whole lot of time to show you the alignment setting. It's nowhere as seamless an experience as on Windows. But worry not, you can solve this issue with a completely free app called Rectangle. You can learn more about this app and other best free Mac apps by watching this video next. Thank you so much for watching and have a fantastic day.